Hello everyone. As you know, in the last video session, we have discussed about the electrostatic potential. And today our next topic is potential gradient. Basically, we will derive the relation between the electric field and the electrostatic potential. So just let's start. As you know, here we are having the charge, and due to charge, electric field lines will get generated. And I want to bring this charge from position B to position A. It means I have to cover some distance, and that displacement I took as dl. I want to carry this charge from position B to position A. Charge is getting displaced. Work is done to carry the charge from one position to another. I have to apply some force also, and this force I am applying in the opposite direction. Electric field lines are in that direction, but charge I have to move in the opposite direction. So if I discuss about the theta, it will become 180 degree. Why it will become 180? Because I want to carry the charge in the opposite direction. This charge will move anti-clockwise, not in that direction. In that direction it will move. So angle will become 180 degree. Here we got 180 degree. So let's start. As we know, the work done per unit charge is equal to electrostatic potential or potential difference that we have discussed in the earlier topics. dV is equal to work done per unit charge. As we know, work done is equal to force into displacement. Work done is equal to force into displacement. So here displacement we are taking as dr, or you can take as dl also as per your convenience. F dot dr divided by q. Now the equation is dot product. When we will open the dot product, which value will come over here? F dr cos theta. Because we know whenever we are opening the dot product, we get cos theta. So dv is equal to F dr cos theta divided by q. As we know, F is equal to Q naught T, because the Coulomb's law, we have derived that relation and discussed also. F is equal to Q naught T, but here we are dealing with the charge Q only. So in this case, we will take F as QE. So we can put the value in place of F. That is QE dr cos. Now theta is 180 degree divided by Q. Q will get cancelled out by Q, and what you will get then? dV is equal to cos 80. Now the value for cos 180 is equal to minus 1. As we know, the value for cos 180 degree is equal to minus 1. So EDR in place of cos 180, I put minus 1. It will become minus EDR. DR will go with the numerator sign. So that is our relation between electrostatic potential difference and the electric field, which is very important. This relation clarifies one thing, that if the difference between two points, this region will be small, then electric field will be more, and if this region will be more, electric field will be less. So that was the topic of potential gradient, or it can come in the form of the relation between electric field and the potential difference. Next topic that we will do in tomorrow's video session, that is electrostatic potential due to prime charge. So for today, just practice this derivation and have a nice day.